Ryan Presley is now pitching for the Astros. Tigers are down 8-2 to the Astros. Top of the ninth inning. Kerry Carpenter's up to bat for the Tigers. He's 0-2 today. Strike one on Carpenter. He swung on and misses. Oh, and two the count on Carpenter. To the count on Carpenter. Low 2-2 the count on Carpenter. The count on Kerry Carpenter. He's up there with nobody out for the Tigers. They're down by 6, 8-2 to the Astros. Carpenter grounds it to first. One up, one away from the Tigers. Here comes Eric Haas to bat. He's 1-2 today. Eric Haas walked in the seventh. Haas. He swings and misses.
Even Herzog is beginning to wonder.
Of course, we are challenging nature itself, and it hits back. It just hits back, that's all. And that's grandiose about it, and we have to accept that it is much stronger than we are. Kinski always says it's full of erotic elements. I don't see it so much erotic, I see it more full of obscenity. It's just, and nature here is vile and base. I wouldn't see anything erotical here. I would see fornication and asphyxiation and choking and fighting for survival and growing and just rotting away. Of course, there's a lot of misery, but it is the same misery that is all around us. The trees here are in misery, and the birds are in misery. I don't think they sing, they just screech in pain.
I don't do too much talking these days. These days, I seem to think a lot about the things that I forgot to do. And all the times I had the chance to.
Hey,
days I seem to think about how all the changes came about my way.
It's an unfinished country. It's still prehistorical.
And I wonder
the only thing that is lacking is the dinosaurs here. It's like a curse weighing on the entire landscape. And whoever goes too deep into this has his share of that curse. So we are cursed with what we are doing. It's a land that God, if he exists, has created in anger. It's the only land where creation is unfinished yet. Taking a close look at what's around us, there is some sort of harmony. It is the harmony of overwhelming and collective murder. And we, in comparison to the articulate vileness and baseness and obscenity of all this jungle, we, in comparison to that enormous articulation, we only sound and look like badly pronounced and half-finished sentences out of a stupid suburban novel, cheap novel. And we have to become humble in front of this overwhelming misery and overwhelming fornication and overwhelming growth and overwhelming lack of water. Even the stars up here sky look like a mess.
These days
there's no harmony in the universe. You have to get acquainted with this idea that there is no real harmony as we have conceived it. But when I say this all full of admiration for the jungle. It is not that I hate it. I love it. I love it very much. But I love it against my better judgment.
Where I'm going, I'm on my time, but I don't know where. What about a rose, a queen of Corona? See me in Julio down by the schoolyard. See me in Julio down by the schoolyard. We'll be right back.
supposed to be? Who am I supposed to be? Look at me. What am I supposed to be? What am I supposed to be? Look at me.
Thank you.
Stephanie says that she wants to know why she's given half her life to people she hates now. Stephanie says,
Stephanie says,
when answering the phone, what country shall I say is calling from across the world? But she. It's all in her mind. It's all in her mind. Stephanie says that
she wants to know
why it is, though she's the door. She can't be alone.
Stephanie says,
but doesn't hang up the phone. What seashell sea is calling from across the world? But she. It's all in her mind. It's all in her mind. They're asking, is it good or bad? It's such an